Good evening. Konbanwa. So thank you for inviting me to have a lecture in Miami. So this is the first time for me to come to this area in the U.S. And yeah, in Japan now we have a very big snow, and comparison from the this kind of cold weather, I think today is almost a paradise for me to enjoy the sunshine and beautiful weather. But today I prepared one lecture title is Architecture Behaviorality, Creating Better Accessibility to the Local Resources. So I put several examples of in this lecture as a practice. And firstly, I would like to introduce what is architecture behaviorality. Last August, I started to teach in Zurich's ETH. And my professor title is also the architecture behaviorology. But because Bow-Bow tried to explain to how the building will be more kind of related from the surroundings. And this theory to kind of the testing to the possibility of the architecture to utilize for the investigation of the social framework in a kind of media of the society. And this behaviorology, so we focusing on the, for example, as an object of nature, or human, or building, and also the thinking about the relationship between the space and nature, human buildings, or architecture and architecture. And also the in this professor research, also that I try to give the some methodology. It's called architecture ethnography, but later so I will explain to the next in this May show of in Venice what I try to do, and also the it's also related to the, this Venice exhibition, and also the we are very happy to work on the graphics or drawing. So the, I would try to teach the how to explain this kind of behaviorality through this graphic method. What is architecture behaviorology? So for example, I think here you have a very big hurricane, so same as Japanese typhoon. So. And this is also the kind of the nature of the behaviorology. And also that in Japan we have an earthquake. This is also one of the behavior of the earth. And also the people react from this kind of disaster. And also that we focus in on the human behaviorology. For example, in this case, we try to find how people behave in a public space, and how public space were activated with the people gathering. Because each country or each climate related to the, this kind of behavior. For example, upper example is Copenhagen in the summertime. It's very different from Miami, I think. Summer is still so in Copenhagen, it's very, very so. Chilly and cold, but night, if you see the people sitting in the bathtray side, maybe people can enjoy the heat from the bathtray because they collect the heat in, during the daytime, and even if the weather is very cold in the evening, in the summer, so they can get some heat from the back wall. Or cherry blossoms in Japan is April, it's very, very so particular season. We enjoy the drinking under the cherry blossom tree, so we should do this, something like that. So, because the Japanese people love to, how can I say, a lot of the memory, a lot of the history or narrativeness, so this kind of happened under the cherry blossom. So that's why so we enjoy the time and we enjoy the spring. And also that we have some research about the window. This is a kind of also important element of the behaviorology in architecture. Window has a several diversity format according to the climate. This book was made by Yoshiharu, my partner. It's called the Windowscape. In the case, they collected many windows from the all over the world and make a drawing, and then so shooting the photograph, and they made several cities about the window how it's working on in each city and the landscape. For example, when we see the window, each city has a different type of the window. And the collection or reputation of the window, it makes also the landscape or streetscape. So it's also very interesting element. And also the very, it's also the very interesting social element. In this window scape, we try to explain why it's happened and something like this. And the studio Bow-Bow 88 set, so we test in 6 days, 6 years, a different topic to comparison between the Japanese case and the Switzerland or Europe case, and to make some sort of the format of the behaviorology, what's happened. So maybe we can provide after the 60 years, I'm very glad to show you or share your account. Okay, now I will try to start to do some examples. Why we started to think about this kind of things? One big event was 2011, so we had a very big earthquake. And after the earthquake, of course, in Tokyo has a very big shaking, so, but we are not so much damaged by tsunami. So under this condition, we are keeping the safe, but also the as an architect, we are thinking, so we started to think so what we can do for this kind of disaster. And then 3 months later, the city of Ishinomaki in Miyagi Prefecture, we found that they had a very so few people for kind of making the interview to the local people to get the idea from the recovery for the recovery. So maybe so we can help them to this kind of local interview to the local people. And we visited in July with my students and also other 20 professor architect with the student group to go and to meet the local people and to start to have a conversation to get some idea of the recovery for the city government. And this is a photograph, so my first images. you saw the many of the houses were gone by the tsunami, and some houses are still existing. And what is the purpose of this visit? So this is a kind of look. The purpose is looking for the new residential area up on the hill. So because the lower part were going to be prohibited to live or to have a house for the local. So that's why so we need to find some new space or new area for residents. And we walk up on the mountain, and we see some stepping vegetable field impact. But last 60 years, the fishermen started to plant some cedar tree, Japanese cedar tree, on the vegetable garden. And it was grown, so not so good way, but we also saw some many resources in the back mountain. And then we tried to make some project for them to make a recovery house after the disaster. And we proposed a core house. That means at first they can make a small house, and if they have a new business and you've got some budget for making the house, they can extend the time by hand. That is a plan of what we propose. But unfortunately, this is a house where we made for them, so because the fishermen started to complain, so, or they said so to us, so, what is the poor house and what, they don't understand only from the visual images, so that they want to have a look. So that's why so we proposed them to make a poor house, model house, for the small community center for the area. And we built with many sponsors the company. And then it was built, and everybody are very happy to see. But one problem is, in fact, so after the disaster, it's also very difficult to find the labor for making the building, such as so many amount of the buildings. So that's why, so in fact, and also the Tohoku area was originally, or before the earthquake, that they were already, that their population was decreasing and decreasing. So because of the contradictional condition from the city side. So because the young people wanted to go to the city, and not just the old people were staying in the villages. So that's why so my house not so well built in the last 20 years. So that's why so building business or my using kind of timber resources business, so that is a little bit that are very not so active for the businesses. So that's why so after the disaster, in fact, it's very difficult to find to have some certain method to create the house from the local labor and local material, because already these local resources were detached from the building process. So that's why we, after the disaster, we proposed them and we wish to connect, but unfortunately it's very difficult to bring them together. So that's why, so that after the 2011, so we tried to test several things, but unfortunately, so we found also the lot of gap between the resources and our culture or our living condition. And now that I'm also showing some example how to connect to the resources. Now we test other countries. For example, this is one example in Germany. We participate in interesting project run by the RAM Labo, and it's called Ostang Project. Darmstadt in Germany, they have a very interesting World Heritage area. Heritage area, and then It's called Matilda Hill. And they have several Art Nouveau or decision type of the building style. And then this is a very famous wedding tower. And also there are several art residence area. And now that's Matilda Hill was kind of expo building in 100 years ago. And then the city Darmstadt wanted to promote to be the World Heritage register for the kind of anniversary of the 100 years. And then, but also that they found some places, it was occupied by the lot of the tree next to the main part and in between the neighbor residents. And then the project is a kind of a campaign for this anniversary register project. And then we participate for the making this kind of activities. To help the city to activate the forest to put some public space. And then this is a group who are invited to this project. Many architects from over different countries, and each of them propose one building for the inner forest. And then we propose one main building for the gathering, 100 people to share something event. And then one architect from Berlin, so he's Alex, and then he is a kind of main project manager architect in charge of the building. And then what is an interesting thing is all building done by the students and also art and architecture students or young people to building by themselves. And then he is a kind of a leader of this building project. And 6 weeks, the 100 young people staying the camping next to the site. And at first they started to make a workshop. And then they are separated to the several groups for each building and to build the end. In this 6 weeks, so I and Yoshi were participating in first period and mid period sometimes. And then, but it was a very interesting atmosphere. Everybody creating something, so sometimes the joint or making joint. And also they make a kitchen by themselves, and also shower. So this is also kitchen, almost outdoor, but they will have a roof. For example, the water coming to the in a very simple way. And also one of the interesting things, the 6 week, every meal provided by these participants. And also the architects sometimes. For example, I was invited one night, so, and at first I thought I will do lecture. But in fact, I did soup. for me, it's the first time making soup for 150 people. And it was really a big challenge for me. Okay, so, and then one interesting story is, well, maybe cultural difference. I tried to make a miso soup with pork meat, tonjiru. So, and then I asked the German students to buy the pork meat. And in Japan, the pork meat is very so small, normally so small pieces or very sliced. But they bought such a very large block of the pork meat. And then maybe so I took slight small pieces, so it took almost 2 hours to so it's a very big work part of the making cooking. Yeah, I think this kind of collaboration with the food is also very simple. Collaboration architecture is also very good, but sometimes it's more, sometimes hard, but well, with the food it always, I think, makes sense. And yeah, this is a view of the interval. So, for example, this is the main building where we design, and there are opening of the frame, finishing the frame of main frame, and we celebrate the structure finish. And carpenter, they wear the classic, the costume as a carpenter, and then so we celebrate that together. And also the interesting thing is construction level in Alex Pilon. One of the graphic designer, he did also the several silk screen print on the site. And he made t-shirts, or he made a signage, or everything very instantly. So this is also very good method in a structure side. And also, it's also very interesting. So when they make a kind of bent timber, the renting the steam, very special steam machine from the Tonet company. Tonet is a very famous bending timber chair factory. And then so they they designed their own special design, so called furniture. And we set also the 100 chairs in our main room. So this is a view of how going on in daily life. And the project, my building, what we design, it's very simple. The two-sided roof. And one side of the bottom, two-sided bottom part could be opened with gravity, kind of one hinge, one side of concrete, and if we take out the pin from the floor side, and naturally, so the concrete side will coming down, and the door could be opened like this. And this space could be utilized as also the sometimes stage. And also, sometimes we can eat that together in a room. So this is an idea of the project. And we had a very nice experience for collaborating with different people to make a building. So. And this experience makes us more another idea for making a building. This is a very recent project in Hamburg we proposed. The project is based on a proposal for the community center for refugee people. Because now the Germany designing, or Hamburg itself, so decided to received many refugees from Syria or Afghan zone. And then they tried to make a kind of a framework for receiving how they can receive from this kind of population. And then this project was organized by the university and also the city to proposing to kind of the collaboration chance to with the refugee people and refugee people and the normal also people to working together to building or designing process, to share the designing process. And then so they proposed to the six architects group to have a workshop with a different group. And for example, our group, I and our staff, and also some students from Germany, and they are coming from different background, Afghan, Iran, or Iraq, or Syria, so on. So. But what is a very interesting thing is, of course, we can say they are refugees, but originally so they have their own professions. And for example, civil engineering, or carpet craftsman, or architects, or several so really so professional background we found. And then that means almost maybe I might be also could be a refugee at some certain moment. Or maybe they have also a lot of the different struggling, but they have also their own history. So that's why, so in this project and workshop, we try to more focusing on the what they have or what kind of skill they have to bring into our proposal. And this community center stands on the edge of the social housing block. And this block was also located in the kind of edge of the city, but they have a very beautiful garden, and also they have a beautiful kind of garden city residential area. And here also the another social housing zone. So that means the housing, new social housing block stands a very in between the residence, very historical residence area, and the new housing area. So that means how we can manage, and also the important part is the city should also convince to the neighbors. So that's why so the project it will be very public or communal things. Otherwise, this kind of positioning is very so difficult to going on the project. As you see, for example, house in the residential garden city area has a very so big, kind of traditional, so large house, German house. And this is a new housing block for social housing. The house was lived not only for refugees, my young students, and also some young family or elderly people. But they try to make a mix the usage. For example, I was also very interested to visit there. For example, for refugee house or apartment, that this is a normal living room, but it will be used for three person. And because of the using the different way for normal way, so they have so many different concept for. For example, today everybody have a mobile phone and computer or a refrigerator, so something like so. The consent were a little bit many, so two, well, three times more than the normal houses. But that also, what is the difference? So that's all. And then this workshop, we try to collaborate, what we try to study to the very simple way to how to collaborate. For example, first day, we asked to them, or not only them, so from our side too, so we introduce our family network by drawings. But what is the interesting thing, because my staff Tamotsu, so he couldn't speak in German, and then so mostly so they can speak only the German. So in fact, in between the our staff and so them, so they have no language almost. So that's why so, but he pointed out that so maybe it's better to draw everything. So he started to draw, and then everybody bring their own history. And second day, so they have a workshop about the home, so home in home country. So everybody draws their own house plan. So it's also very interesting to how different from Japanese house, for example. And then mostly, so that the people has a very big, large living rooms because they have a very big party, home party. So that's why they need a kind of space for the gathering. And the third day, so we have discussing about the public space in home country. And we realize also, this is a kind of bazaar. And also how they make selling things, etc. We share these kind of things. And the fourth day, so we think about just planning and structure. And also the fifth day, so we continue. So, but one we propose to them, so. From the conversation and workshop, maybe we can make several living room in a space. So because many family or in an apartment, there is no space for gathering, so unfortunately. So that's why so maybe in this kind of community center, we'd have several living rooms for different community. So. And also, we found some, well, we need to design, we need to build very so quick in the process. So that's why so we thought maybe so we can utilize some container or this kind of simple frame unit. So we propose kind of 9 grid frame and then make a different the roof by homes, because one of the carpenter in our group, they in a workshop one day, so he made a very beautiful roof, for example. So that if we can make this kind of roof by themselves, so it might be also very interesting to create a space by home. But unfortunately, I think after the refugee, so they were refugees, so they couldn't work until to get the permission. So that's why so they have a lot of time, and but they have a own profession before, so maybe so this kind of project would help them to support their kind of profession or kind of like recognition or not trust their own the profession. And in a workshop, the end of the workshop, so there are very big. We have a very nice audience from neighbors. And for example, I and come on to explain to the neighbors what is the purpose and what is the idea. And the other five groups were also presented to the audience. And then finally, so we were selected as an architect to propose the community center. And now that we start to design with the local architect. But very so simple structure. So the, as I mentioned, this is almost the same size of the container unit. And it was divided into the 9 different rooms. You know, one or sometimes it will be open to the outside. And sometimes it has a kitchen, and sometimes it has a more workshop space. So this is a view to the interior. So we can share the different living room to walk through the inner corridor side. Yes, this is a view so for future. And the next project is the timber network. My recently, Bow-Bow are very so interested in the timber issues. So because after the 2011, we also found some difficulty of the access of the timber resources. And we tested several projects in this topic. But this area is called Katori, and across from the Narita Airport. In as you see, the area where so many valley, but this brown part was valley. And the green part is a mountain. And if you see high level, so lower valley part was occupied by rice field, and mountainside was covered by cedar trees. And one welfare NGO started to make some sort of welfare project in this countryside because mostly the population of the this area were farmers. And my farmer, Japanese farmer, is very so very strong, how can I say, very strong culture. But also one big thing is that there is not so much caring facilities like an elderly house or disabled people daycare center, etc. So the this NGO was founded by kind of member of the farmer's family or farmer's society. And they established the kind of new organization for create this kind of welfare service structure in their local area. And then they made 3 elderly house at first, and the fourth is this project. And then we started to support or collaborate with them from this project. But this project is called Loving Pork Laboratory. Now why Loving Pork? because the chair of the organization ran the pork meat farm. And then they started to think about how connected the agriculture, business, and welfare service. And then they, maybe so they can make a branding their own pork meat as a new brand. And then the selling and advertising of this pork meat as a new brand. And then in this kind of frame, so, of course, normal people working, but also some disabled people can join the job. So this Loving Pork laboratory have several functions in it. One function is making sausage and ham and shabshab meat for selling. And the upper part is a restaurant of the pork shabshab meat. And also the another part was the office of this organization. And how people can share the work. For example, a cleaning in the service or restaurant, so it's a very important job. So he is some disabled, mental disabled program, but he have some job for the cleaning, so. And also, he also have some problems of the mental, but now he have a kind of job to the open door in front of the restaurant. And then I think the photo was taken 3-4 years, but now I think he was very encouraged to work here, and when we visit here, so sometimes he works as also working in the restaurant too. So yeah, I think that means if we can give them to opportunity, or if we can open the opportunity to work and share in this kind of things, I think it's also very very important. So for their independent condition, because one problem is now in Japan, so sometimes it's very difficult to find a job for them, and this organization trying to produce the job space for everyone. And now, after this project, the chair of the organization, Mr. Ida, he started to think about the forest, because behind of their buildings, there were many forests, and as you see, the forest was not so taken care of the last 10 years. And then it was very dark, and a lot of the weeds happened. Well, weeds are growth, and then it was not so healthy condition. And so Mr. Ida started to maintain the forest, and then so cutting some small trees to give it more light from above, and also the cutting the weeds. So now the back side of the building forest were going to healthy and healthy. So. And then after this project, he was asked several times from the neighbors, farmers, because of their age, they couldn't manage also the forest beside of their work. Because the forest was originally planted by them, but nowadays they gave up to they gave up the business of the timber as a job. So because of the, I think, 1970 after World War II and 1970-80s, so the Japanese forest industry was damaged by the imported timber from North America. because the comparison between the cost, so it's very difficult to survive as a business. So that's why the Japanese forest industry was totally damaged now. So, but recently the tree was kind of having a good timing to be cut as a material. So now the Japanese government started to promote the utilization of the possibility of the utilization of trees. So something like, so the, I think now the time is coming, something like that. And then he also thought maybe so this could be also a good framework for the making new job space for normal people and elderly people, or and also disabled people together. So now we designed one timber workshop for them, and the main building, main workshop, and one side is office, and one side is daycare center for the elderly, and here is a furniture workshop. And here is a sweet potato factory and sweet potato shop. Cake, sweet potato cake, sorry. So, and this is a firewood. And what is the main production of them? It's firewood. For example, normal way of the making the firewood is with ox. To the cutting, so one by one. But they found one machine for cutting to or making the small pieces with this damper, oil damper machine. And then it would be very good for everybody to have a chance to work. And then so we make some work process sheet to from the cutting tree from the forest and making the firewood and the last time of the making the wrapping to for the distribution. So and then we also find that which part could be shared to the disabled people. So the this frame part will be much easier or nicer to work with them. So the this is a kind of dividing job process sheet mapping to think about how we can share with everybody. And also we made a manual because of this NGO did already several different works for them. So in this case, we helped them to make a manual. And this project also helping to, or connecting, making the connecting to the neighbors or local timber workers or forest workers. And also we found a lot of the local factory, timber factory. And we asked them to collaborate for our project. And after this research, we made an actor network mapping. For example, this is our proposal project. And this building, how connect to the different people. So for example, of course, they connect to the neighbors, farmers, and also that they connect to the neighbor's timber factory, and also they can connect to the Loving Fork laboratories people, and also the many workers coming from the city area or Tokyo, who work for the big company as a disabled people. So because now the company should have some workspace for the disabled people, some certain percentage. But unfortunately, sometimes it's very difficult to find a good job for them. So this is a kind of frame for the kind of collaboration with this kind of company who wanted to hire the many workers from the disabled people. So the this NGO tried to make a matching place for all. And this is a project what we propose. This is the building, main building. It has a three roof and some simple open roof. And this is the process of the how to cut a tree. Well, we tried to cut a tree from the forest next to the site, and we asked to the him, my locals, or timber workers, and then he make a tree, and this tree points to the factory and the old computer, so use the traditional tools to make a joint in a special sort of way. And in November, we have a very big festival for same as the Germany case, to finishing the frame, so main frame. And in Japanese case, we throw the rice cake from the roof to the guest. So this is the view of the party. And this picture is last week. So we have a snow, so that's why. but it will be finished next week. So very, very soon. And you see, for example, this kind of timber has many different color. So because of the, in the market, sometimes people don't want to have this kind of differentiation of the color. So, but we know that this timber where comes from the local. So we could understand and we enjoy the difference of the color. I think this kind of thinking or networking is also very important to recognition of the what is material or where come how material coming to the place. Okay. This is the last project. Maybe I need a little bit to rush. 2011, I explained to the Tohoku disaster, and then so I still continue to work until today. But this is my explanation about this story. And it's called Oshika Peninsula, one of the most recent damaged area by tsunami, because almost 13 different small fishermen villages existing around. And Aki is a kind of a platform of the Japanese architect, 300 architects working or sharing some information for the after the disaster. And we established one organization. And this project run by this organization. And I and Yoshiharu have our own laboratory in different university, and we participate in the different part of the village. For example, I'm working for these three villages, and Yoshiharu working for these four villages. And in this support, recovery support, but this is also very important for working with the city or city government. But we don't want to be different, but because the recovery process sometimes is very, very, should be rush, and also should be run by, leading by the the city government, because the city government organized all budget and etc. So that's why, so basically so our position is following or supporting the city government, but also we try to give some more communication platform between the city and the local people. That is our intention. And then, so because of this reason, so we try to make a several proposal to share the information. Well, for example, this it's called the pattern book. Well, I think we learned, but we found also that after the Katrina hurricane, so then some U.S. group make some pattern book for the recovery. And we saw that this kind of things would be very good way and for the helping understand what's happening in the future. And and then so we made have some research and also the one of the things is we also made some graphic incorporated component by different subsidizing the project in one future images. For example, harbor were organized by fishermen's sector, and for example, here residents were organized by residents sector. And the road is organized by, the, for example, prefecture. So the recovery coming time and time in this local city or local village, but everything was divided as administrative. So that's why so sometimes the people cannot reach the images, whole images, what happened after the recovery. So the goal of this book is giving them to the, some idea to how it's going to be. And after these things, we found also the one problem of the area, because the fishermen's village were already aged, and then they lose a young population, and also the, they need more younger fishermen so to sustain their community. And then one old fisherman, he's the chairman of the village, he pointed, okay, let's make a fisherman's school in among this community. And then so I totally agreed with his idea, and I and him so together working to establish the fisherman's school. And first, it was started to 2013, and now that we finished just last week, so we finished the 2009 fisherman school. So that means every year two fisherman schools happen. And fisherman school normally simple program. Fishermen teach to them to the what is a fishery, and also they practice in a real experiment. And also the old fishermen showing the around to the area. And we also learned so the how to cook or how to slice the fish. And also we, in this project we made a textbook in the fishermen's because normally so fishery were not so exposed in paper. That we got the fisherman request to the younger fishermen so to learn from their attitude or manners. So that means that there is no writing, so very few writings. That's why so we try to give some more open gate to the newcomer. The textbook will help them to come in easily. And after the third fisherman school, so we realized also the, some problems because we need more people, not only for fishermen, to help their community to other aspects. And then fourth one, so we tested another topic with the fisherman school. For example, fourth, we proposed the fisherman school with thinking future images. Then in this fisherman's school, so we can collect several new social background people. For example, he working for the United States, United Nations, sorry, United Nations. And then he working before the underdeveloping country or some helping, supporting. So the maybe so he also the very different field, but he are very have a lot of the knowledge about the supporting of the society or community. And also we did the ones and cooking or eating food, fisherman's school. So and in this case, the participant can propose to the local people to the new recipe or new menu using local fish or local vegetable. And after, so we started to think about another problem, so making a new land for newcomer because the higher part were developed by the government, but it the area of the residents were allowed to only the local people who lost their house. So that even we make several fisherman school, and we found a newcomer who want to live in the new community. But unfortunately, so there is no space for living. So this project was kind of the starting point for proposal to them to thinking about the new residence area. And we did, for this project, we did also the one discovery, the traditional route to the area. And also we make one fisherman's school to discover how to utilize the mountainside or hillside of the fisherman village. And after these workshops, our fisherman's school, so we found one area would be good for developing time by time to make a new village for newcomer. And then after 8th fisherman's school, we proposed a mountain fisherman's school. So the mountain means we thinning the tree and managing the forest and proposing to the utilize of the possibility, showing the possibility of the mountain use. In this case, of course, we catch a fish, but also we cut a tree and we make a timber and we made a chair. And after this, we started to propose one camping site and also the dormitory place for the area for exchange from the outside and inside the culture. And we found a very good collaborator, AP Bank. And AP Bank is founded by a very famous musician in Japan. But he made several charity concert. And after this concert, he had a very big fund. And then so he used for the lot of the ecology or sustainable the project in Japan. And we asked him to support our project and he agreed. Now this village will run with him. And in this project, we also thinking about that the whole process would be also as a school to learn from the nature and the Fijian village culture. And we propose a very simple building, the same, a little bit similar planning of the traditional fisherman's house. And also, we asked the young generation architects to make a small cottage for the area. And we started to cut a tree as a volunteer with a volunteer group. and open the forest. And also the path of the this camping area was also covered by the leftover timber from the forest. And we make a camping site by ourselves. And also this is a one-day workshop, workshops with the volunteers. And in our volunteers, we run a autumn project. We made also same kind of lunch cooking to eat together. And the timber was cut and also sliced to the local timber factory. And yeah, like these images. But we proposed summer school to the area. And we made two cottages in a process in 2 weeks by 20 people together. Some of them coming from my school, but some of them coming from the as a volunteer. So it's very mixed community for making building. So this is the result, what we designed. Our main house designed by us, and two houses designed by young architects. And house were very simple, so almost 20 to 30 people staying there, could stay there, and sharing the food and also the making some learning workshop. And site is originally, it was also the vegetable garden for local people. So stepping with local field. Then we keep the original site condition. And these two cottages were something like that, and all timber was coming from the forest. And he is a musician, but he supported our project. And this is the opening day, he played the music, and we have also the some opening day event to the local people, and also the in the audience. And this is also very interesting kind of sort of photograph. For example, this is me. And this is an 88 years old fisherman. He grown up in here, and he still working as a fisherman. And he is a very famous musician, Kobayashi Takeshi. And he is also he's a newcomer. He came 2 years ago to be fisherman, so the fifth. Graduate the fifth fisherman school. So the maybe so we cannot imagine without this kind of disaster 2011. But after so we meet and now we collaborate together for this project. And this is also very important. You can stay here so if you like. So there is also English kind of flyer, so I can send to your school. And if you are interested to come to Japan, so welcome to come to this place. And recently, so we also focusing on the traditional the timber board to make some sort of a special exhibition. And also we are thinking about making workshop for stone wall, traditional method to learn to recovery of the damage of the stone wall. Yes. And this is the last slide. So, but now what we are doing now. But to 20th century, yes, 20th century, we, in the early 20th century, so our life it's very connected to the resources directly. So for example, nature, human, skill. But as learning from the fisherman, so 88 years old, I found that he connected a lot of the local resources. But now, 20th century, so late 20th century, so a lot of things were industrialized and a lot of too institutionalized, and then we cannot easily to connect to the resources, unfortunately. And then we call maybe there are barriers somehow. And then how we can destroy, or how we can skip or jump over these borders or barriers. That is maybe a question what we want to do. But maybe so we cannot go back to the 100 years ago, so maybe it's not so easy to just go back to the 100 years ago, but maybe we try to find in between to think about the hybrid situation. But we don't know exactly the answer, but in every practice or every case is we test different way, and I hope we can find the answer time by time. And last slide is 2008 May, I curate the Japan Pavilion in Venice Biennale. And the theme is architecture ethnography. And I collect the around 40 projects from all over the world, kind of visualized of the condition of the society or city or rural area. And then we collect the 40 project, and then after, so we are thinking what is the purpose or what is the goal of this kind of method. In the lower part, we want to make a kind of market of mobile furniture, a bar or bookshop or etc. And after the collection, maybe we can have some discussion in a market. So I don't know exactly what's going on, so it's still an ongoing project, but I hope if you have a chance to come to Venice and join our project, it's very, very great. So thank you very much for all.